I'm here with David Cooper and Charlotte King of Butleigh Girls School. It's very special that you're here because it's the first time that a school actually attends a NECE conference. So David, please tell me something about your school and why you're here.
So a little bit about the school. We're just under 1,300 students. We're all girls. We're 11 to 18 years old. We take mainly from the communities of Butleigh and Dewsbury, which is in West Yorkshire. Has experienced a number of challenges in recent years, socioeconomic, but also Jo Cox was our local MP. She was murdered just out very close to our school, actually. So part of the role of the school is to build a community, to build a sense of pride and self-esteem and status. And we've been able to embed a long-term vision on that because we have a distributed leadership model. So myself and the other co-head, we've both been there at the school for 23 years, so for us it's about a long-term approach and effective citizenship, democratic participation of our young people, enabling student voice, empowering our young people has been critical to that school journey that we've been on.
So basically just gave us also a definition of what citizenship education means for you. So how do you do this actually?
Well, to me it should be absolutely embedded in the holistic curriculum that we have. It's not just the formal taught curriculum in terms of the subjects that we offer, which obviously we think very carefully about, but it's then down to the choices that we make in terms of the pedagogical choices that we might make as educators, but it's also, for example, in terms of English literature, careful thinking of the text that we might use, but then also it's the wraparound experiences that we give our young people. So the fact that we're able to bring our students to this conference today, they're the only young people at this conference, you know, and I think actually we've got a duty as teachers and school leaders to actively look for opportunities to not just include young people but actually base what we're doing around what young people are asking for. Mm-hmm. And that's really essential, very important to us as a school.
Charlotte, you are hosting a workshop today. Tell us something about the workshop, what it's about, and how do the young people engage in this?
Well, the workshop was something that began almost 2 years ago now, and we were working with Michaelis and Kath, who are from Leeds Beckett and York St John Universities respectively, and they came into our school to work with the story of the Odyssey. And what it was all about was looking at the themes and the ideas within the Odyssey and the characters that exist within that Odyssey. But what it wasn't just kind of a storytelling situation, it was about bringing out the kind of latent and the kind of moral and emotional ideas within that and relating it into a wider context, into the students' own context as well. So the students did some poetry and they did some artwork around that. And then that developed when other schools that were involved and our school came together in a linking project almost, where the students shared each other's work and got to know each other and spoke to each other about their own separate situations and how the story had affected them, which was a really, really powerful thing. It's been really, really effective for the students. I think they've really enjoyed having that, having a voice, using the Odyssey as a way to express their own ideas.
What can you learn from the Odyssey for today's politics or for acting as a political citizen?
I think the story of Odysseus travelling through the world and the way that he encounters different cultures and different places and the way that is dealt with. We were talking particularly a moment ago about a point in the story where he arrives in a new place and he is lost and he is naked and he has nothing. And the way that society welcomes him in and it feeds him and clothes him and respects him. I mean, there are all sorts of ideas there that relate to immigration issues and kind of respect issues within the societies across Europe and that is really, really prominent in the world today.
It's great that you're here and showing, giving that to other people too. Thank you very much. So have a safe journey home and enjoy the conference.
Thank you very much. Thank you.